Hello friends, how are you? In this video, we'll talk about cost-effectiveness of the hypothetical value of the population variance. Now, to test whether a random sample xi has been drawn from the normal population with specified population variance sigma p square. The null hypothesis A0, the variance is sigma p square. That is, the variance is sigma p square. And alternative hypothesis, sigma square. So for two-tailed test, sigma square is not equal to sigma p square. The population variance is not equal to sigma p square. In left tail test, the population variance is less than sigma p square. And in the right tail test, the population variance is greater than sigma p square. Here, sigma p square is the assumed population variance. Chi-square test of the population variance. The calculated value is chi-square is equal to n minus 1 s square divided by sigma p square, where a square is the sample variance, sigma p square is the assumed population variance, and n is the sample size. And degree of freedom is n minus 1. Now, decision for rejecting the null hypothesis. For two-tailed test, if chi-square is greater than chi-square alpha by 2 comma n minus 1 and chi-square is less than chi-square 1 minus alpha by 2 comma n minus 1. So if this is the case, then we have to reject the null hypothesis. For left-tailed test, if chi-square value is or calculated chi-square value is less than chi-square 1 minus alpha comma n minus 1. And for right-tailed test, if chi-square value is calculated chi-square value is greater than chi-square alpha comma n minus 1, where the significant level is alpha and degrees of freedom is 9 minus 1. Now, summarily, we can calculate the confidence interval also. So, the 100% 100 into 1 minus alpha square confidence interval of population variance is the confidence interval, the population variance should be in between this particular value and this particular value. A class instructor believes that the standard deviation of the number of students absent per day is greater than 5. A random sample of 12 days is selected. The data are 10, 3, 4, 6, 9 and so on. At alpha is equal to 0.05, is there enough evidence to support the instructor's claim? The standard deviation sigma p is 5, hence the variance is sigma p square is equal to 25. We apply right tail test. Now null hypothesis is sigma square is equal to 25, the population variance is 25, because already you know for every time null hypothesis always should be equal to, and since the instructor claim is that the number of student absent per day is greater than 5, so that's why we have to use the right tail test greater than, and already hypothesis is what sigma square is greater than 25, the population variance is greater than 25. Now the sample data are 10, 3, 4, 6, 9, this is the sample data, and its variance is 10.75. The calculated, the sample variance is 10.75. Now the calculated value is n minus 1 into s square divided by sigma p square. So total number of sample 12, so 12 minus 1 11 into the calculated the sample variance is what 10.75, and assumed variance is what 25, the answer is 4.73. Chi-square alpha comma n minus 1, that is alpha is equal to 0.05 and n is 12, so 12 students are there, 12 minus 1 11, and the table value is 19.675738. So we can see here alpha is equal to 0.05, okay, and the degree of freedom is 11, and here the table value is what 19 point, this is our table value, so this is nothing but a chi-square table. So where the alpha is equal to 0.05 is the level of significance and the 11 is the degrees of freedom. So from this particular table, using alpha and degree of freedom, we can get the table value, and the table value is what 19.675138. Now as you know that for right tail test, if calculated value is less than chi square alpha comma n minus 1, then do not reject the null hypothesis. Since the calculated value 4.73 is less than the table value 19.675738, hence do not reject the null hypothesis, and that is the evidence does not support the instructor's claim. Now chi-square test for the population variance using R. So here you capture the absent, okay, here you have calculated the standard deviation and the variance, and it is a sample variance, you just remember. And this is what calculated chi-square value. The answer is 4.73. And in this way, you can get the table value. Okay. And since that the table value is what 19.655738. Since the calculated value is less than this particular table value, hence do not reject the null hypothesis. That is, the evidence does not support the instructor's claim. Now, in another example, we can see the radii of 8 washers are measured and the values are 2.2, 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, and so on. Test the hypothesis that sigma square is equal to 0.09. That is, the variance is 0.09, where the level of significance is alpha is equal to 0.01. Now, I apply two-tail test. So, null hypothesis is what? Null hypothesis, sigma square is equal to 0.09. The population variance is 0.09. And already hypothesis is what? Sigma square is not equal to 0.09. The population variance is not 0.09. So, this is our null hypothesis. And this is our alternative hypothesis. So, we have to, first of all, we have to calculate the sample variance. The values are, these are the values. And from the given values, we have calculated the sample variance. And the sample variance is 0.0353. Okay. So, from this particular data, we can get the sample variance. And sample variance is this one. Now, the calculated chi-square value is, we have to calculate the chi-square value. So, n minus 1. So, total number of samples is 18, 18 minus 1, 17 into the sample variance, divided by the assumed variance. So the calculated value is what? 6.6678. Since the calculated value, chi-square value 6.6678 is more than the upper limit. Okay. So here we have to calculate the table value. So alpha is equal to 0.01. So we have to calculate this particular table value. So chi-square 0.01 divided by 2 comma 18.1. So chi-square 0.005 comma 17, and the table value is what? You can get this particular value from the table. Chi-square table, and this is the upper limit and the lower limit. This is the lower limit. We can see chi-square 1 minus alpha by 2 comma n minus 1. So 1 minus 0.01 by 2 comma 18 minus 1, that is chi-square 0.995 comma 17 is equal to, so this is our, this is the upper limit chi-square table, and this is the lower limit. So all these two values came from the chi-square value, chi-square table. Since the calculated value is more than the upper limit, okay, but less than the lower limit, hence reject the null hypothesis. The limitations of the chi-square test are as follows. Chi-square test becomes difficult to interpret if the table size is larger than 4 by 4. If the table value is more than 2 by 2, there is no correlation method available for small sample size. Chi-square is sensitive to the larger sample size. Doubling the sample size doubles the chi-square, and for larger sample, very small differences can be significant. It implies cause rather than association. Spurious relationship cannot be recognized. And that is the end of this particular video. Thank you very much.